Sa video nito, pag-uusapan natin kung ano nga ba itong invalid traffic. Since April 1, ang dami sa ating mga nakasama natin dito sa YouTube, mga content creator, ang nawawala ng ads o nadi-disable ang kanilang ads. Everyone, welcome back to my channel. By the way, kung bago ka pa dito at di mo pa ako kilala, I'm MJ Raim. I love to share some tips about YouTube para sa mga gustong mag-grow ang kanilang mga channel. I do some basic tutorials too, like how to create your thumbnail, your channel banner, at iba pa to make our YouTube channel more presentable. Ano nga ba itong invalid traffic? Ano ba ang naidudulot nito sa ating channel?
Invalid traffic includes any includes or impression that may artificially inflate an advertiser's cost or a publisher's earnings. Invalid traffic covers intentionally fraudulent traffic as well as accidental clicks. Ayan, pwede tayo ito yung definition ng invalid traffic, guys. Ito yung ibig sabihin ng invalid traffics. Yung mga any clicks or impression that may artificially inflate an advertiser cost, yung ano, nagpapalaki ng binabayaran ng isang advertisers. Ito yung mga dahilan kung bakit tayo na-invalid traffic. Ito yung mga dahilan kung bakit na-disable yung AdSense ng ibang content creator. So, ano ba ang mga ito?
Clicks or impressions generated by publisher clicking their own live ads.
Ito yung pag-click natin ng sarili nating ads, guys. Pwede tayong ma-invalid traffic doon. Ayan. Another one, repeated ad clicks or impressions generated by one or more user. Yung pag-click ng paulit-ulit sa ating mga ads, guys. Pwede tayong ma-invalid traffic doon. Publisher encouraging clicks on their own ads. Example, you may include any language encouraging user to click on ads, an implementation that may cause a high volume of accidental clicks, etc. Ayan, diba guys? And next is automated clicking tools or traffic source, robots, or another deceptive software. Ito yung mga gumagamit, guys, ng mga robot, yung mga bumibili ng views. Yan, yung mga bumibili ng views, bumibili ng subscribers, yan, mga bot, yung robot na tinatawag dun, guys. Usually, itong mga ito, guys, nakikita ito sa external natin.
Napaka-low ng binibigay sa atin na view duration. Ito yung mga robot na to. Like, yung mga, usually, guys, yung mga na-disable ang AdSense earlier, yung mga merong mga white rabbit sa kanilang mga external. Yan.
Clicks on Google Ads must result from genuine user interest, and any method that artificially generates clicks or impression is strictly prohibited by our program policy. If we observe high levels of invalid traffic on your account, we may suspend or disable the account to protect our advertiser and user. Ayan, guys. Pwede daw i-suspend o i-disable ang account natin kay Google AdSense pag napatunayan nilang naglabag tayo, di ba? Naglabag tayo sa kanilang program policies.
If you are unable to verify the quality of your traffic, we may limit or disable your ad serving due to invalid clicks. You may also see difference between your estimated and finalized earning. Diba? We understand that a third party may generate invalid traffic on your ads without your knowledge or permission. Naiintindihan daw nila that minsan may third party may generate invalid traffic na hindi natin alam, wala tayong knowledge about it or permission.
However, ultimately, it is your responsibility. Responsible natin, guys, na pag-aralan natin yung mga traffics natin dun sa analytics natin. As the publisher to ensure that the traffic on your ads is valid, for this reason, we highly recommend that you review our tips for preventing invalid traffic. Ano bang itong mga tips ni AdSense para ma-prevent, para maiwasan natin ang invalid traffic? How you can help to prevent invalid traffic? Paano daw natin ma-prevent ang invalid traffic? Diba? Kasi napakahirap, guys, paghirapan natin yung ating channel, diba? And then mawawalan tayo. Wala nang silbi ang ating channel, guys, pag ma-disable na ang ating AdSense. How to keep your account in good standing? Ayan. AdSense publishers are ultimately responsible for the traffic on their ads. For this reason, it's critical that you diligently monitor your ad traffic to ensure that your account is compliant with our policies and not occurring invalid traffic. If you see something suspicious after following the tips below, you're become to notify ads. Notify daw natin sa Google AdSense if may nakikita tayo sa ating analytics doon sa ating yung mga third-party application. Doon visually nang gagaling kung bakit tayo na-invalid traffic.
We encourage you to review the information in these resources. Ayan guys, pwede nyo itong basahin AdSense Policies as Beginner's Guide, AdSense Program Policies, AdSense Terms and Conditions, Ad Traffic Quality Resources Center. Ayan guys, kung may oras kayo, pwede kayong pumunta dito sa AdSense Help. I-search nyo lang yung invalid traffic and then mababasa nyo itong mga ito. Pwede nyo i-open kasi talking about invalid traffic ay napakalawak nito. Napakalawak guys. Now guys, I just want to share o basahin ko dito kung ano ba yung mga tips na kailangan natin gawin para maiwasan yung invalid traffic. Tips to help you prevent invalid traffic on your ads. Ingatan natin yung ads natin guys kasi true ads, dyan tayo kumikita.
Understand your ad traffic and site visitors. Diba? Understand your traffic and site visitors. Saan ba nanggagaling ang mga nanonood sa atin? Aling traffic source ang mga nanonood sa mga video natin? Diba? Break down and traffic reports into meaningful segments using URL channels, custom URLs, or ad units. This will help you how changes to traffic sources or implementation can affect your ad traffic. Next, use Google Analytics. Ito yung analytics natin guys, to get detailed information about your site visitors and be on the lookout for any suspicious user behavior. Where do may users come from, either geographically or on the web? Which pages do they view on my site? Ito yung sinasabi guys kung saan ba nanggagaling ating mga viewers. Kailangan natin pag-aralan ang ating analytics. Kaya napaka-importante guys na alam natin i-interpret ang ating analytics. So, avoid partnering with untrusted, low-quality partners. Diba? Avoid. Iwasan daw natin ang makikipag-partner sa mga untrusted or low-quality partners. Some publishers had issues with invalid traffic when partnering with low-quality ad networks, search engine, or directory sites on efforts to increase traffic to their site. About, diba guys? Inyo guys, pag gusto nyo itong basahin guys, you can check one by one like this purchasing traffic. Pwede nyo itong i-check by yourself guys. Kasi we have enough time. I don't want to make this video too much longer. So, if you want it, guys, just go to AdSense Help and then click it, guys, and check it one by one. And then, next is don't click your own ads, even if you think it's okay to do so. Huwag daw natin i-click ang sarili nating ad. If you're interested in an ad or looking for its destination URL, clicking on your ads is still prohibited. Keep in mind that even we filter clicks on your ads, we don't ignore these clicks completely. If it appears to us that a publisher has been clicking on his own ads to inflate his earning or advertiser's post, we may disable the account to protect our advertiser. Iniingatan nila yung mga advertisers. So, syempre si Google AdSense, iniingatan din niya yung mga advertisers na yun.
Double and triple check. Tripling pag-check ng ating double and triple check your implementation. Some publishers use custom implementation that may have unattended consequences on their ad request. Make sure your ad implementation confirms to our ad placement policies. Ayan guys, if you have time, you can check this out guys, yung ad placement policies, because if I press ko din yan guys, or i-click ko, talagang hahaba yung video na dito. But if you have time, again and again, you can check it by yourself. And has no programming error. Also, check your ads in different browsers and platforms to ensure they work as you expect, di ba? Responsibly natin guys, di ba? Na i-check ang ating mga ads sa saan nang gagaling, o check your ads in different browser and platforms to ensure they work as you expect.
Ayan. Next is consult the AdSense Help form. Ayan, AdSense Help form. Gaya itong ginagawa ko guys, dito ako nagsa-search o nagre-research dito sa AdSense Help. Ayan. If you have any questions, it's likely that another publisher has encountered the same issue, so join in a discussion. To learn more or start your own, let others know if you encountered a third party or situation that tends to generate invalid traffic. Yan ang sinasabi guys, pag alam nyo may nakakaduda o nakakaduda doon sa analytics nyo, much better na let us know o ipapaalam natin sa may mga alam, di ba? Mga nagtuturo about YouTube. So don't hesitate, huwag tayong mahiyang magtanong kung healthy ba ito ang mga pumapasok, yung mga pumapasok na view sa ating mga video, di ba? O yung mga views o yung about ating analytics guys, di ba? Much better na pag-aralan natin yung AdSense Help, di ba? Especially itong invalid traffic kasi napapansin ko nowadays na every month may mga na-disable ang AdSense.
So that's it for today's video guys. Hopefully may natutunan tayo about invalid traffic. Once again, this is MD Rayam guys. Anyway, if you like this video, please do like and share, and also subscribe, guys. Ayan, maraming salamat, guys. See you again on my next vlog. Bye-bye!